to start them talking. The chest should be on the bolster. The lower limbs should be in abduction, external rotation, knee extension. If in cases if the child is wearing ankle foot orthosis, the child can wear ankle foot orthosis. Okay, so the first exercise is prone push-ups using bolster or ball. The first I'm going to demonstrate on bolster. So when I'm doing these exercises, okay, the child should be come on prone. Yes,
prone.
Yes. Chest should be here.
Chest.
Hand should be down. Okay, knees extension. Yes. Okay, knee extension. I mean elbow extension. Elbow extension. Up. Look up. Abduction. Okay. So this is prone push-ups using bolster. The main use of this exercise is it facilitates the abdominal muscles and the serratus anterior muscles. The bolster should be at the chest. Okay. The hand should be taking weight on the floor. Elbow should be extended. The important thing is that the lower limbs, hip should be abduction. Come on. Relax. Abduction, external rotation, and the knee should be extension. The therapist should be behind the kid. Understand what I'm talking? The therapist should be behind the head. The kid should be looking up. Okay. Someone should be playing with the kid. Some kind of visual and auditory input is very, very important. Okay. Okay, so this is prone push-ups using bolster. Okay, there is something, the same thing we can do on physio ball. Okay, how we can do on physio ball, please? Okay, I'll show on this kid. Okay, it is the same position. Okay, the kid should be on prone line. Okay. It should be supported till the chest level. Okay, the kid should be taking weight on the hands and should come up with the hand weight bearing and elbow extension. The same thing, the therapist should be behind, the lower limb should be in abduction, external rotation and knee extension. Okay, so in this position we can encourage the kid take weight bearing on the hands with elbow extension and looking up. The therapist should be behind supporting at the pelvis. Sometimes even we can assist the elbow extension. Once the child is good, can maintain his posture, then we can ask the kid go for reaching out activities with one hand. Okay, so mainly this activity is to facilitate the serratus anterior muscle and the abdominal muscles. So that is the main purpose of doing this exercise. This is prone push-ups using bolster and using physio ball. Understand what I'm talking? There is second one, prone push-ups on bolster with knee on the bolster. I'll show that exercise. Come on, prone. Knee should be here. I'll support. Yes, I can go. Go forward. Yes. Yes, relax. Okay. So this is prone push-ups with knee on the bolster. Okay. This is the progression of the exercise. Once the kid is stable, once the kid can do in bolster and physio ball, then we can progress to these prone push-ups with bolster. So the main thing is that it facilitates the serratus anterior muscle and it facilitates the abdominal muscle. So this is the main use of this activity. Understand what I'm talking? Okay. Any questions regarding this exercise? that's about the first activity and the first exercise. The same thing I said, go on push-ups with knee on the bolster, upper extremity weight bearing, facilitates serratus anterior and abdominal muscles. You know, important, the lower extremity should be hip abduction and extended rotation with knee in extension. The important thing, the knee should be on the bolster. Okay, in case if you are not able to maintain that position, we can use some kind of weights. We can ask the kid to wear ankle foot orthosis to maintain the ankle in neutral position. Okay, so that is about the first exercises which helps in facilitation. The second one, squat weight shifts on bolster. In the initial I was talking, you know, some of the muscles which go for spasticity, among that is the plantar flexors which go for spasticity. Okay, so we have to stretch the plantar flexors, especially soleus muscle. So we are doing this activity. Okay, squat weight shifts on bolster. Now mainly we are lengthening and strengthening the soleus muscle eccentrically. How we can do this exercise? We need a bolster. It's okay, I'll show this. Okay. The kid should be squatting. You know squatting?
Yes.
Okay, the kid should be in squatting position. Okay. The therapy should be behind, holding the lower limbs. Okay. The lower limbs, the weight should be taking on the important thing, lateral aspect of the foot by femoral extended rotation. Okay. The kid should be little bit forward. Okay. Ask him to stand up and squat. Understand what I am talking? The center of gravity of the kid should be forward. The hands can be supported or cannot be supported. But the important thing is that, okay, the kid should squat and should come up and should squat again. So by this what happens? It lengthens and stretches the gastrosoleus muscle eccentrically. That is one of the important thing. Please 1 minute. Can you sit on the legs? Squat. Yes, 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 good. Yes, good. Squat. Sit. Squat. Yes, yes, no problem. I'm there. Yes, yes. Okay. So this is called squatting. I'm just starting talking. My hand should be here. Okay. The kid should be, center of gravity should be forward. Now we ask the kid to stand up. Can you stand up? Yes. Okay, sit. Okay, this is the exact activity. Okay, the important thing, thank you. The important thing, the weight bearing on the foot should be on the lateral aspects. So that is the important thing. So this activity will help to lengthen and strengthen the soleus muscle eccentrically. Understand what I am talking? When the kid is standing, it is lengthening. When sitting, it is strengthening. Understood? So that is the squat weight shifts on bolster. Okay. Is it clear, this exercise?
Yes.
Next is sitting on bolster with legs abduction and trunk extension. So you can see, we can use bolster or we can use ball. The leg should be in abduction and the trunk should be in extension. Basically this is for two exercises. Okay, so first one I'll show with the bolster. So this is for two things. One is it stretches the hip adductors. Next one, it facilitates the trunk extensors. Okay, come sit like this, legs apart. Yes, sit. Okay, so sitting on the bolster with legs abduction, understood, and the trunk should be in extension. Okay, so by doing this activity, we are stretching hip. Yes, we are stretching hip, adductors. Okay, we are giving a basketball and ask the kid to throw the basketball. So by this, we are facilitating the trunk extensions. Okay, so any kind of weight shifts when the kid is throwing the ball will increases the activity of the core muscles. Understand what I am talking? So this is for two things. It helps to stretch hip, adductors. It helps to facilitate the trunk extensors. So we can ask the kid to take any kind of basketball and ask the kid to throw the ball. So when the kid is throwing, weight shifts are happening. When the weight shifts happens, the core activity, the core means the trunk, the muscle activity in the trunk will increase. Understand what I am talking? So this is the main purpose of this exercise. In this exercise, we can incorporate trunk extension and rotation, whether it can be active or it can be passive. How we can do active trunk rotation? I am asking the kid to take this. Can you take this pen with this hand? With this hand. So in this, what is happening? Trunk rotation and spinal extension is happening. Okay, this is active. If you want to do passively, okay, I'll just support it and I help to rotate. So with this activity, we can do three things. We can stretch hip, adductors. We can facilitate trunk extensors. We can do active or passive trunk extension and rotation activity on both the sides. Understood? When you want to do active, the child should take the object actively. It can be on the right side or it can be on the left side. Passively, if the kid is not able to do it, the spine is very much stiff, then we can passively, we can help to rotate the spine. Okay, so that is about sitting on bolster, a ball with legs, abduction and trunk extension. There is one more activity, sitting on bolster with one leg abduction and other leg knee extension. This is for hamstring elongation. So basically this activity is for main for hamstring elongation and hip adduction. We can incorporate trunk extension and rotation activity also. Please come. Can you come back? Back. Okay. So we need a bolster. Okay. The therapist should be sitting behind the kid. One knee should be in extension. Put it on the bolster. Understand what I'm talking? The other knee should be abduction. So, which leg we are stretching hip abductors, which leg we are stretching hamstrings?
This is hamstring. Right hamstring.
Okay, good. The right leg we are stretching hamstrings, and the left leg is we are stretching hip adductors. Okay, it's very simple. Okay, the kid should be sitting straight. I should make sure that I should support the knee joint in extension and make sure that, you know, the other leg should be abduction. Now I'll ask the kid to reach out for any kind of activities with this hand. Can you reach out? With this hand, yes, reach out. Take some object. Yes. Understand what I'm talking? When the kid is going for reaching out activities, we are actively stretching the hamstrings. Understand what I'm talking? So by along with this activity, we can even incorporate, what is this? Trunk extension and rotation. First, passively we have to facilitate. Once we get passive range, then we can go for active trunk extension and rotation. Understood? So why this trunk rotation is important? Any idea? Why trunk rotation is important? If you are seeing most of the activities, I am incorporating trunk extension and rotation. Why trunk extension and rotation is important for a child, especially for spastic diplegic cerebral palsy child? Because, yes, because as I was saying in introduction, you know, these kids, the muscles are very spastic, it will be very stiff. Okay, when I'm standing, when I'm walking, trunk rotations are happening. If my spine is very stiff, I have to walk like a robot. Understand what I'm talking? My spine have rotations, especially in the thoracic region. That's why I'm able to walk. Normal people can walk because they have rotations in the spine. If we don't have any rotations, we can't even walk properly. So that is the reason we are incorporating trunk extension and rotation in most of the activities.
There is a name for it.
Sorry?
Shifting. The shifting weight.
Weight shifts. You're talking about weight shifts? Yeah, weight shifts. Weight shifts is important. Plus, range of motion in the spine also is important. Okay? So for all the activities, you know, we are giving weight shifts. Weight shifts, when the kid is reaching out activities, the weight is shifting to one side. Understood? So in almost all the activities, there is weight shifts and there is active muscle contraction. Okay? And we are not doing for one muscle. We are doing one exercise for 3-4 muscles. The same exercise, I am stretching for hamstrings on the right side. I am stretching for hip adductors on the left side. And I am incorporating trunk extension and rotation of the spine. So after that, we can change to this limb. We can put this limb in hip extension and this in hip abduction. Okay, is it clear? So that is about sitting on bolster with one leg abduction and other leg knee extension. The next is side sitting on bolster with one leg cross or other leg. Okay, it is very simple. It is the same position. The therapist should be behind. The kid should be sitting on the bolster with knees locked so that the pelvis will be stable. No. Yes, behind. Okay. So we are locking the knees because so that the pelvis can be stable. So basically we are giving trunk rotations. Okay? So when I position like this, I am rotating towards the right side. One hand of therapist should be at the sternum. Okay? The thumb and the thinner aspect should be on the paraspinal muscles of the trunk to the side which is rotated. Understand what I'm talking? Please do remember that this is very, very important. Okay? I am locking the knee joint on the left side. Okay? I am rotating towards right side. Understood? Your hand placements are very, very important. One hand should be on the sternum. Sorry. The thumb and the thinner aspect should be on the paraspinal muscles at the mid thoracic region. Okay? And just rotate it towards the right side. Okay? If I want to rotate towards the left side, I will change the leg position. So I am locking the knees because the pelvis will be stable when I am rotating. If I don't lock the knees, the pelvis will not be stable and the whole body will rotate with the pelvis. Okay, when I lock the knees, the pelvis will be stable. Okay, one hand should be on the sternum, the thumb and the thinner aspect should be on the paraspinal muscles to the side which is rotated. And please rotate at the thoracic region, mid thoracic region. Don't rotate from the sternum. Sternum is only for grip. Understand what I am talking? This is passive trunk rotation. Before this, I forgot one point. Before doing any kind of trunk rotation, you should get spine extension. Understand what I am talking? Some people's spine will be flexed. So please get first spine extension. Then do rotations. Without spine extension, please don't rotate. The rotation will not help at all. So first get the spine into extension. Then you rotate the spine. So it should be at the thoracic, at the paraspinal region. So you should use the thumb and the thinner aspect of the therapist hand. Okay. So this is about side sitting on bolster with one leg crossed on the other leg. Okay. The next is latissimus dorsi muscles lengthening of the ball. So I was telling there are some important muscles which go for spasticity. Among that, latissimus dorsi is one of the muscles. So today I'll be demonstrating how to lengthen the latissimus dorsi muscle. To lengthen this latissimus dorsi muscle, we need a physio ball, and we need other two therapists to support the leg and the upper limbs. So I can't demonstrate here. Okay, if I want to lengthen the latissimus dorsi muscle, the kid should be in sideline position. The therapist should be behind the kid. Okay, I need extra two therapists. One therapist will be giving traction to the lower limbs, both. Traction to the lower limbs. The other therapist will be giving traction to the upper limbs. The therapist, one hand will be at the lower part of the scapula, the other upper part of the iliac crest. Understood? I am crossing my hands and I am maintaining this for 1 minute. So by this I am lengthening the latissimus dorsi on the right side. So please do remember that the kid should be in sideline position. I need two other therapists, one therapist to give traction at the lower limbs. The second therapist should give traction at the upper limbs. The therapist should be in walk standing position behind the kid. Okay. The hand of the therapist should be in the lower part of the scapula, one hand. The other hand should be on the upper part of the iliac crest. The hands should be crossed, and we have to maintain this crossing of the hands for 1 minute. Okay, this is basically myofascial release. So because this muscle, the fascia, because already the muscle is spastic, the fascia will be having spasticity. So I am releasing it by doing this activity. Understood? So this is latissimus dorsi lengthening on the physio ball. Okay. The next one is pectoral. Pectoral is major. So this is also one of the important muscle which is very spastic. So we can do three things. We can do passive, we can do active assisted, and we can do active elongation of pectoralis major. First, always when you are doing any kind of activity, first we have to do passively. Once we get the range, then you should go for active assisted and active stretching. The first I will demonstrate is the passive stretching of pectoralis major muscle. When you want to do the passive stretching of pectoralis major muscle, the kid should be supine lying. Okay, the pectoralis major has two fibers. One is horizontal fibers, the second one is oblique fibers. Okay, when I want to stretch the horizontal fibers, both the hands should be abducted to 90 degrees of shoulder abduction with extended rotation. Some therapist should be there where the therapist should be holding the hands to 90 degrees of shoulder abduction. The therapist who is will give the activity should be in front of the kid. Understand what I'm talking? So the hands should be at 90 degrees of shoulder abduction. Okay, someone should hold the hands, some other therapist. So what I'll be doing, I'll be putting one hand on the shoulders, other hand on the second to sixth costo-sternal junction joints. So I'll be crossing the hands and I'll be maintaining this hand crossing for 1 minute. So basically we are releasing the spasticity in the fascia of the pectoralis major muscle. Okay, I'll be holding it for 1 minute. For oblique fibers, 120 degree, I'll take the hand little bit up 120 degrees and ask someone to hold. Again, same, I'll repeat the same procedure for 1 minute, crossing the hands. Okay, so this is passive stretching of pectoralis major. Okay, so please do remember that there are two fibers, horizontal fibers and oblique fibers. When you are stretching horizontal fibers, the hands should be abducted to 90 degrees with external rotation of the shoulder. If you are doing the oblique fibers, it should be at 120 degrees. Okay, so that is about passive stretching of pectoralis major muscle. There is one more muscle, there is active assisted stretching of pectoralis major. In the active assisted, the pelvis should be on the ball. Okay, we should take the kit down like this. The hands should be weight bearing on the floor. And this is what I am talking. Only the pelvis should be on the ball. Some other therapist should be in front and holding the hands with elbow extension and supporting on the floor. In this, the kid should do push-ups. And this is what I am talking. So by doing this, we are stretching two muscles. One is pectoralis major muscle and one is latissimus dorsi muscle. So please remember that.
In same time,
this activity. So again, I'll tell you. This is active assisted stretching of pectoralis major muscle. The kid should be on supine lying on the ball. We should take the kid down. Only the pelvis should be on the ball. The hands should be on the floor. The kid should do elbow push-ups with the help of other therapist who will be helping the kid. Okay, by doing this activity, we are stretching, active assisted stretching of pectoralis major muscle and latissimus dorsi muscle. So that is about active assisted stretching of pectoralis major. How to do this active stretching of pectoralis major muscle? It's very simple. In this, the kid should be on prone line. Okay, the therapist should be behind the kid. Okay, there are two fibers. One is horizontal fibers, the second one is oblique fibers. If you want to stretch the horizontal fibers, okay, maintain the hand in 90 degrees of shoulder abduction, external rotation. So ask the kid to actually come up. Head should come up, head extension and trunk extension like this. And this is what I am talking. So when the kid comes actively with trunk extension and head extension, automatically the pectoralis major muscle will get stretched actively. Okay, if I want to for oblique fibers, my hand should be at, the kid's hand you have to maintain at 120 degrees of abduction for oblique fibers and ask the kid to come up. Okay, head extension with spinal extension will stretch the pectoralis major muscle. So basically it is passive, active assisted and active. Two fibers, horizontal fibers, 90 degrees of shoulder abduction. Oblique fibers, 120 degrees of shoulder abduction. Okay, when I am doing passive, active assisted, the kid should be in supine line. Active, the kid should be prone line. When I say active, the kid should do it actively as much as possible. We have to just support the shoulders at the required angle. Whether it can be 90 degrees, whether it can be 120 degrees. Okay? So these are some of the important muscles which go for tightness or spastic in the upper limb and lower limb. So that is the reason why we are giving stretching and facilitation techniques for spastic diaplegic cerebral palsy. There are some remaining other activities or stretching techniques. I will discuss it in next lecture. If you have any queries, any questions?